Los Angeles, California. It's cool, you know, it's like a family thing over there, and I never was signed to anybody before them, so it's true. YG made that up. He made it up doing like a song. He had said it in a song. And I just, I don't know why I did it. I just stuck to it and just fucking kept using it on all my beats. And that shit just caught. Ten Summer Records is just like my new record label. New artist. We got new artists. I don't want to say too many of their names because everything's not official yet. But it's a record label with UMG. Universal Music Group, and so we're just now starting getting it off the ground. I just like the party. I think it's exciting to see people just react to older music. And I do EDM as well. I just mix a lot of hip hop into it. So being a DJ makes it easier for me to produce, really. Really, I just go in and play my music and just like play as if it was a party. Now I'm doing more of like a set where it's like a show and not just like a club. So it's kind of hard to explain, but it's like everything has edits now and it just like more thought out. Travis brought me the record like a while ago when he was working on his album, and I was supposed to work on it then, and me and Metro actually did like a beat to it, but it wasn't right. It was a tight beat, but it wasn't what the song was supposed to sound like. So we kept that beat. I went back to the original with Jean-Baptiste and started, and then I added a drop, added some vocal chop with a couple of my people, and played it back for Travis, and I was like, yo, let me just use this for my singing. He was like, for sure, let's go. And then I worked on it some more. I probably worked on the song for like 3 to 6 months, and just got it sounding how I wanted it to sound, and now it's out. I think this will be my crossover. I went into this record not thinking that if everybody likes it, it's gonna be a hit. I started thinking of if I could break the barriers of doing this, it's like an EDM / hip hop / R&B track, then I could do anything I wanted to do. And now, obviously, it's working and people like it. So if I can control both worlds at the same time, which is EDM and hip hop, then I don't see where I couldn't do it. You know what I mean? Not to everything. I'm still gonna do my regular for the summertime. But it might be another song coming like that soon. I'm not gonna say who, but it might be something crazy. Travis is cool, man. He's real, like, innovative. He's real, like, he's not as hype as you would think he is in the studio, but he's like, you know what he wants. He's a star. Like, he's just a good dude to work with. So, I enjoy working with Travis. He's cool. Now, I just start listening to more music, listening to trap, listening to EDM, and just listening to everything and seeing where I wanted my sound to go. And just how I would progress my sound. And really, I just start trying stuff. I didn't really think it out. I just like start trying stuff. I start doing like, remixes and stuff like that. And once I got those down pat, I'm like, okay, I can do a single like this now. I like DJ Snake. I like Diplo, of course, Skrillex. I like Calvin Harris, he's super crazy. The new dude, Marshmallow, he's super hard. 4B's dope. Salva, it's crazy. I like Arnold Grind. There's a lot of them out there, man. It's actually very hard. Yeah, I'm planning on working with Vic. I like Chief Keef. I like Dirt, Reese. I like all of them. All the Chicago rappers are pretty dope. I like Lil Mouse, he's tight. It's a lot of Chicago rappers is tight, though. Shining up that way. I'm just gonna go hard. I'm gonna go my hardest and just try to get exactly the best that I can get out of all the people in the crowd. I'm gonna go crazy. I don't have no worries about that. I'm ready. Yeah.
I won't.